Today I'm going to explain you the chapter The Adventure of Toto by Ruskin Bond. About the story. The Adventure of Toto is an amusing story written by Ruskin Bond. The narrator's grandfather loved animals so much that he had his own private zoo. One day he brought a baby monkey named Toto from a Tonga diver for a sum of 5 rupees. He had other animals such as a tortoise, a tiny squirrel, a pair of rabbits, a pet goat, and a donkey. Toto was a little red pretty monkey. He had bright mischievous eyes along with pearly white teeth. His tail also added to his good looks and served as a third hand. Toto's presence was kept secret in the house, especially from grandmother, until she was in good mood. Toto was kept in a little closet in the narrator's bedroom wall, tied to a peg on the wall. A few hours later, grandfather and the narrator came back to release Toto. They found the ornamental paper has been ripped off. It stood out as naked brick and plaster. The peg has been wrenched from its socket and the narrator's school blazer has been torn to shreds. The narrator was worried about grandmother's reaction, but grandfather was pleased with Toto's performance and says that he is clever enough. Next day, he was kept in the servant room along with other animals, but he didn't let them sleep all night. As grandfather had to go to Saharanpur to collect his pension, he decided to take him along with him to Dehradun next day. Grandfather took him in a big black canvas kit bag and closed it so nicely that he couldn't escape. In the railway platform, he jumped and rolled inside the bag on the floor. He attracted a curious crowd of onlookers. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur, but while grandfather was giving the ticket, he poked his head somehow out of the bag and grinned at the ticket collector. The ticket collector charged extra 3 rupees from grandfather for Toto. Grandmother finally accepted Toto and was given a comfortable home in the stable with the donkey, Nana. Toto cut onto Nana's long ear with his sharp little teeth. That is why Nana and Toto never became friends. During cold winter evening, Toto was given a large bowl of warm water for his bath. It was a treat for him. Toto was always mischievous. Only one day, he was nearly boiled himself alive in the kitchen kettle. Toto always used to be tear things to pieces. Once narrator's aunt came near him, he teared a hole in her dress. Once at lunchtime, Toto was found a large dish of pulao on the dining table and started eating it. When grandmother screamed, Toto threw a plate at her. An aunt came forward, but Toto threw a glass of water at her, then ran away with a dish of pulao set on a jackfruit tree till evening. With intention to spite the grandmother, he threw the dish down the tree and shattered with delight when it broke into pieces. Grandfather had realized that Toto was not that sort of pet could keep for long. As they were not well-to-do and could not afford the frequent loss of dishes, clothes, curtains, and wallpapers. So, grandfather sold Toto back to the Tonga diver for only 3 rupees. So, this Adventure of Toto is an interesting story, isn't it? About a mischievous monkey. Toto was brought by the narrator's grandfather from a Tonga diver for a sum of 5 rupees. Narrator's grandfather was actually a great lover of birds and animals, and he has a private zoo where he takes care of many birds and animals, which includes tortoise, rabbit, squirrel, goat, donkey, etc. And Toto was a new member to that family, whose grandfather brought from a Tonga diver for 5 rupees. From the very first day, Toto began to display a lot of mischief. He was very different from other animals. Toto used his tail as a third hand, and he used to hang from a branch and for scooping up any delicacy that might be out of reach of his hands. Toto could not let his co-animals live in peace because of him. Grandfather also faced many awkward situations. There were many things about Toto which were also very enjoyable. For example, the way Toto examines the warmth of water to take bath and drying himself near fire. But more Toto grew up, more mischievous he began. His mischief touched the extreme when one day he sat in dining table, ate the food and threw the plate to grandmother's. Ultimately, grandfather decided to give Toto back to the Tonga driver for ₹3. So, this is the story. I hope you understand this. Let's see the question answer. Thinking about it, how does Toto come to grandfather's private zoo? Grandfather was having a fascination for the pet animals. He loved animals so much that he had his own private zoo. He kept animals that he liked. Once he saw a little monkey tied to a feeding trough, and the monkey looked out of place there. So the grandfather decided to add the monkey to his private zoo. He brought Toto from the Tonga driver for ₹5. Question 2. Toto was a pretty monkey. In what sense is Toto pretty? Toto was a little red monkey. He had bright mischievous eyes beneath deep set eyebrows, along with pretty pearly white teeth. His tail also added to his good look and served as a third hand. In this sense, Toto can be said to be a pretty monkey. Question 3. Why did grandfather take Toto to Saharanpur and how? Why does the ticket collector insist on calling Toto a dog? Toto was a mischievous monkey. He didn't allow any of his co-animals to sleep at night. He kept disturbing all other animals. So grandfather decided to take Toto to Saharanpur. He took Toto in a big black canvas kit bag. The ticket collector insisted on calling Toto a dog because pet animals like dog are charged with a fee, and Toto was a pet and his size was similar to a dog. Question 4. How does Toto take a bath? Where has he learned to do this? How does Toto almost boil himself alive? During cold winter evening, Toto was given a large bowl of warm water for bath. Cunningly testing the temperature with his hand, then gradually one feet, then the other, until he was onto the water up to his neck. He rubbed himself all over with the soap. He learned it all from the narrator. One day, Toto got in a large kitchen kettle, which was on fire to boil for tea. He found the water just warm enough for a bath. He got into the kettle with his head kept out. When the water began to boil, Toto raised himself a little, but he found it cold outside, so he sat again. When the water turned out to be hot, he jumped up and down. Suddenly, grandmother arrived and pulled him out in half-boiled condition. Thus, with the help of grandmother, he nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive. Question 5. Why does the author say Toto was not the sort of pet we could keep? As per the narrator, Toto was not the sort of pet that they could keep. Toto was a mischievous monkey. He disturbed not only all animals in grandfather's private zoo, but also causes frequent losses in their home. Being a middle-class family, they could not afford the frequent loss of dishes, clothes, curtains, and wallpapers. That is why the author said that Toto is not the sort of pet they can keep for long. Ultimately, grandfather sold Toto back to the Tonga driver for ₹3. There are two extra questions I'm adding here. Why did grandfather keep Toto's presence a secret to grandmother? Grandmother always fuses when grandfather brought home some new birds or animals. So grandfather decided not to tell her about Toto until she was in good mood. Question 2. What are the pets possessed by the author's grandfather? Where did they live? The pets that possessed by the author's grandfather were a tortoise, a pair of rabbits, a tame squirrel, a goat, and a donkey. They lived in the private zoo of the grandfather. This is all for today. Hope you understand the chapters along with the questions nicely. If you like my video, do like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.